hot copy this morning, over 700,000 people are now at risk after being administered with a dengue vaccine that was found to be harmful to those not previously exposed to the disease. Cory Quintos looks back at how the dengue vaccination program came about.
Year 2011, during former Health Secretary Enrique Onna's term, there were clinical trials in the country for dengue vaccine. The Philippines is just one of the 10 countries who performed it. In November 2015, former Health Secretary Janette Garin claimed that there were negotiations during the APEC summit in Manila regarding the vaccine. December 2015, then-President Noynoy Aquino visited Sanofi Pasteur's headquarters when he was in Paris for the climate change conference. December 22, 2015, Dengvaxia was registered with the Philippine Food and Drug Administration. January 2016, Garin announced there will be free dengue vaccination for children in high endemic areas. She also said the vaccines may be purchased at a lower price. January 7, 2016 was the first meeting of the Formulary Executive Committee, or FEC. At the meeting, a member told the committee the vaccine was not included in the national formulary. Some expressed strong objection to the use of dengue vaccine because of potential adverse effects. January 25, 2016, another FEC meeting was held. A provisional exemption for the use of the vaccine using government's funds became an issue. A member of the FEC said the process of evaluating the vaccine takes time, but the FEC is pressed to give immediate recommendation because the procurement for the vaccine had already been budgeted. The FEC expressed it could have been better if the standard process was followed and documents were submitted to the Committee for Evaluation of Exemption before the budget was committed for procurement. It was also stated in the FEC document that the Dengvaxia procurement was not planned in 2015 and 2016 as part of DOH project. However, a political decision to allot the budget from the national agency savings was already made by a higher committee. February 1, 2016, during the third meeting of the FEC, FEC recommended the provisional exemption of the vaccine for a year, but with some conditions, including the readiness of LGUs and schools. March 9, 2016, the Philippine Children's Medical Center made the purchase order for the pilot implementation of the vaccination program. April 2016, the school-based immunization program was launched in Parang, Marikina. A public health expert says there are a lot of questions that happened in the procurement of the vaccine.
Pakabilis ng mga pangyayari. At ito ay ngayon nakikita natin, merong consequence yan. Merong nangyari tuloy dahil dun sa madali ang paggagawa nitong programa na ito.
When former Secretary Pauline Obiol became the Secretary July 2016, she said the vaccination program should stop while further studies are underway. But after receiving a recommendation from the expert panel that one must complete all the doses, she continued with the program and further expanded the immunization in Cebu and other selected cities in the National Capital Region. According to Sanofi Pasteur, the controversy over the vaccine is unexpected.
We conducted the analysis as a research endeavor. You have a hypothesis and you have to test the hypothesis, and whether or not the findings are what you expected or not what you expected, for us, that we need to transparently share and disclose this information.
Cory Quintos, ABS-CBN News.